Welcome to another edition of Pittsburgh Sportsline at Atrias PNC Park. Thanks for coming out. We're in the upper deck, so it's a little different look here. We're on this mezzanine level. It's all decorated for Christmas. Smoking Jim's here with me. I'm Al Levine, the talking machine. This is at 103 Federal Street, right off the Clemente Bridge. Happy to do a show here Monday night. We got guests. And want to thank everybody for watching us on Verizon 32 everywhere in the Pittsburgh area, from Nemacolin to Cranberry Wexford and every point in between that has Verizon. Comcast 7, people are asking about us, but it's only in Bethel Park. We appreciate the viewers there. And Facebook, we've been holding steady around 6,400 likes. I think it was 6,395 the other day, so we're holding it steady there. We appreciate everybody watching and liking our show. And we're going to start our show with What's On Your Mind. It's sponsored by Skeets Lewandowski of Skeets Service Station. He sponsors that. He works on anything that runs on gas, you name it. From weed whackers to boats, cars, trucks, even tractors, I've seen it. So check out Skeets Service Station in Finleyville. You can't miss it. Great place. Take your car. And Monday they have the buffet, Smoking Jim. They got donuts and all kind of things to eat there, and you've been invited every week, so you got to come out there sometime when you got some car trouble. So, but we're going to start the show right now with What's On Your Mind. What's On Your Mind?
Thanks, Al Levine, the talking machine, and if you want the green, whoa, you got to see Levine. I want to thank everybody for coming out. If you haven't done so already, do yourself a favor, grab a menu, because the only burger I like better than a Roth's burger is the Talking Machine Big Mouth Burger. Congratulations to Coach Mike Tomlin getting his 100th victory. Coach Mike Tomlin and myself have what I call an on-again, off-again relationship, and right now it's off again. Since 1969, the Pittsburgh Steelers have only had three coaches, and all the coaches have over 100 victories. But every year, right around this time, I start to miss my good friend, Coach Bill Cowher. Coach Bill Cowher coached the Pittsburgh Steelers for 15 years. He should be in the Hall of Fame. He got 161 career victories. He's a Super Bowl champion, and he's a two-time NFL Head Coach of the Year. Rod Woodson was the best cornerback in the NFL, and he was coached by the chin. Alan Faneca, the best guard, was brought in by the chin. Casey Hampton, best nose guard, brought in by the chin. Troy Polamalu, best safety, brought in by the chin. The Big Ben Roethlisberger, best quarterback, brought in by the chin. Heath Miller, best tight end, brought in by the chin. Joey Porter, James Harrison, both brought in by the chin. The Bill Cowher head coaching tree consists of Dawn Capers, Dick LeBeau, Marvin Lewis, Jim Haslett, Chang Gailey, Mike Malarkey, Ken Wisenhunt, Bruce Arians, and I'm going to include Mike Tomlin, because Bill Cowher left Mike Tomlin all his players, all his coaches, his system, a Hall of Fame quarterback, and a Super Bowl team. In 4 years, Troy Polamalu will be in the Hall of Fame. Before that, put the chin in.
I'm glad we got to pass the mic so I know you're done. P.S., the chin was 8-8 his last year in Pittsburgh with that team. 8-8. And you told me the Steelers are always trying not to be great. So the chin left us that legacy also. I appreciate that, Smoking Jim. The people downstairs enjoyed what you were talking about. They could hear you. Well, I won't hit that volume like you do. So that was quite entertaining. I appreciate it. I'm trying to think what's on my mind. I saw a good football game, predicted the Steelers would beat the Giants, and they did. Or no, the Bills. What am I saying? I'm back a week. I got to catch up. They did beat the Bills. It looked like the game was never out of hand with the Steelers, even though Big Ben didn't have a good game. Three interceptions, just was missing people left and right. But the guy who's shown was Le'Veon Bell, 236 yards running, 62 yards passing. You can walk in front of the camera. We don't mind.
Well done. And that one is going. You could probably put it right on that table.
Yeah. Thank you, ladies. We appreciate Atrias. And the Steelers went on to win the game 27-20, 298 yards of offense by Le'Veon Bell. And he's due a new contract. I hear they're going to make him a franchise player, so they'll have to award him that. Thank you. But it's just amazing with what he did. And it was snowing. It snowed the whole game, which made it even more impressive with his running performance and his catching performance. It's just unbelievable what he's doing. He's been averaging 142 yards per game, but he blew it out with 298. They couldn't get him to 300. What the heck happened there? I know you would have got him 300 so you could talk about it next week, and you missed that. Well, we got a bunch of great guests. We got Jose Carabella's gym.
Woo!
Now, we got a special night here. It's called Lady Boxers Night. And you can tell by Smoking Jim squealing that we got ladies. And, of course, they're going to have to get photos with them. Oh, they already did. But I'm going to have to bring Jose, the leader of the Ray Schaefer Boxing Gym, up first. I'll bring Jose up because we'll have him on early. Then we'll have him on late so he can clue us in with some of this stuff. All right? Jose, are you ready? Let's do it. Look at that haircut. He's a movie star.
How about that, right? Looks good.
Where's the mustache?
I know. It's going. I'm playing on a new film right now with Steve Carell.
Are you?
Yeah, it's the last
I got to keep updates on all this stuff you're doing. It's fantastic. I'm proud of you.
Yeah, thank you. It's called The Last Flag Flying. I play a military police officer, MP. So.
Wow, you're stepping on up.
Yeah. On the last show, I'm also coming out in 2017. I have a Netflix series called Mindhunter. I'm on 3 episodes of that.
Really?
Yeah. And I'm
You're keeping busy, my man.
Yeah, I am.
You're that SAG member now.
Yeah, and I'm trying. I got a new show coming out in 2017, The Outsiders. I'm on that, too.
I've seen people. I know people that are in that movie,
yeah.
Outsiders. Yeah,
yeah,
they've been filming it all year.
Yeah, it's good. We wrapped it up, and I play a prison inmate in there.
Wow. You're expanding your horizon here with the acting. That's great.
Pretty cool. Pretty fun. It is, really. So.
It is. Now, what's with this Ray Schaefer boxing gym?
You know, we got a team. You know, we always do. We come with a team. Usually, I think we signed up last year. We had 16 fighters, a lot of champions, some silver medalists.
Now, it's amateur boxing mostly, right?
Yes.
You're going mostly with the amateurs that we're talking about?
Well, yeah, yes, I am. But Eric Sidnor, you guys know.
My man.
Yeah, he's not going to be fighting in the gloves this year.
Tell me what's going on. He messaged me on Facebook. He had some big announcement, but he couldn't until he talked to you, so I didn't hear anything back from him.
Well,
you tell us.
Yeah, Eric Sidnor, he's going to turn.
He's got the best smile in the business.
He does. Great-looking kid, good attitude, heck of a fighter. He's turning professional.
When, January?
We're going to start getting his license in January and have him fighting probably around the same time or through the Golden Gloves. So.
That's awesome. Tell him good luck. Well, he'll know. Good luck, yeah. Eric Sidnor.
Eric Sidnor,
Paula. We got it. He's the best.
Yeah, so tell me what's going on. What else?
Well, we always have boxers on, MMA people, people that have gyms, and you cover a lot of that. Now, we got the ladies here tonight,
yes.
Lady boxers.
Yes.
We've had them on before. We're going to do individual interviews tonight of each one.
Yeah, that's great.
Because I want to get the word out about them. They can talk a little bit about their, you know, selves and how they got into it. I'll ask them questions. The hardest one is what's their name. Then we go from there.
Right.
Because if they don't know boxing, they can't be on here. I'll call you back, coach.
True.
Because you teach them.
Yeah, and every one of them are champions. How about that? They won the Golden Gloves Championship.
Get out.
So.
Wow, that's even more impressive.
Yeah, it's fun.
Do you know who you want to bring up first? Because you send them up to me, and then we'll introduce them to the folks out here.
Yeah, how about we set up the assassin, Colleen Davis?
We'll do that. All right. I just friended her dad because of a guest, Douglas Kavanaugh.
Great guy. Doug Kavanaugh, great man, boxing historian, really knows his stuff.
He does. You know? It was a great interview with him. If you see it,
I'm gonna
check it out. It's a good one.
I'm gonna catch it.
Definitely. He was telling some stories.
Yeah. He knows a lot, man. He has all kinds of stories.
Well, he researches for 7 years.
I mean, he knows a lot, you know. With talking to him about the history of our gym, we have a lot of sports history in our gym. We have the original ring in 1951. Jersey Joe Walcott fought Ezra Charles.
I remember when I first met you, you told me that.
Yeah, for the world title in our ring, we have the Post-Gazette paper when the Civic Arena donated it over to our program and everything. Sugar Ray Leonard was called in 75 before the 76 Olympics. He fought in that ring. I believe he fought Eddie Chambers' dad, Cutie Pie Chambers.
Yeah, you're right. So Great point.
He fought in that ring there, and that ring went through the Rooney, McGinley, boxing clubs and things like that. So world champion stepped in that ring.
History right here. We had five champions at the time.
Yeah.
Out of eight, which was amazing over that time period.
Yeah, it was.
It's not like it is now.
No. Boxing at one time, and I'm sure Mr. Douglas Kavanaugh would agree, was bigger than New York, Pittsburgh.
Oh, it was huge. Yeah, it was
boxing,
huge.
The boxing.
He even told how a mobster was trying to control Billy Kahn. And Rooney's got hold of it, and then they ended up stopping it. So it was a heck of a story.
He
said, I own a piece of him. And he's like, who are you talking to?
Yeah.
They straightened that out.
Yeah. And that's the thing with Doug. The Billy Kahn times, he knows all about that. And that's huge. That set up all of our things with Paul Spadafora today.
Oh, yeah. Pittsburgh kid. Definitely.
Unbelievable talent right there.
And what about the Puerto Rican prince?
Hey, I'm retired.
How's that guy?
He's doing good, but he's not getting hit. Like, when he's going to work, he's not getting hit anymore. I might get yelled at if I mess up once in a while, but I'm not getting hit anymore.
You found a good career.
Yeah, I did.
Plus, you do this, you love this.
Yeah, I love the boxing.
And I know that. You're into it. We're going to have to throw a flag on the first guest. Uh-huh. There was a guy who come in here first.
Okay.
Doherty.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to bring him up.
And I know he's going to be nervous. It's his first time on it.
First interview. Yeah, but he got the talking machine.
Yeah, I know. So, you got to help him out. Lead the way.
I'll help him out. All right.
Thank you.
We'll have you back on.
I'll talk to you.
We'll have you talk a little more at the end, too, if you're able.
Yeah, I'm able.
I know you can talk with me.
We're staying with the show, man.
All right. Let's do it.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Send him up.
Thank you.
My first question's the toughest one for you.
Yes.
What's your name?
My name is Ryan Doherty.
Thank you. I asked you that before, and you told me the same answer. You're a good guest. We'll have some fun now. Now, when did you start boxing?
I started boxing about a year and a half ago.
Get out. And you're a champ already. How did this even happen?
Well, I was with my friend, and I started watching the Rocky movies, and that's just how I got into it.
Now, tell everybody how old you are.
I'm 12 years old.
Get on. You're watching Rocky movies like all of us, and we love that. So now you want to get hit and hit others.
Yep.
And you're having fun?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Do you work out for it?
Yes.
How many days a week do you train?
4 days a week.
4 days a week. You go to school, I hope, and get an education, too.
Mm-hmm.
All right. What grade are you in?
Sixth grade.
How's your grades?
Good.
Good. Because Smoking Jim believes if you box, you should be homeschooled. Don't go to school. Just stay home. Work out. Punch the bag. Go run around a little. Eat right.
Sleep in.
Well, of course. Look at him. But you're going to school. That's a good thing. Now, how'd you find this gym? Is it nearby?
Yes. It's about 5 minutes away from my house.
5 minutes by car. That's great. So it's convenient?
Yes.
So you don't mind going there each day? It's easy to get to?
Yeah, it's very easy to get to. I don't mind it at all.
That's good. Now, how did this boxing go? You started out, and they said you had some talent. Did they put you in the ring with other kids and stuff?
Yeah, at first there was a kid. His name is Mikey, and we would spar a lot.
Did you like that?
Yeah, I did.
Did you learn anything?
Yes, I learned a lot.
Did they show you what to do?
Yes.
I know Jose's a great teacher. He's a great, great instructor of this. Plus, he fought professionally. Did you know that?
Yes.
Did he tell you?
Yes.
I know he doesn't. He got the same story. I'm looking at him. We'll bring him back up for some updates for sure. Do you have any brothers or sisters?
I have one sister.
What's her name?
Haley.
Is she gonna box?
Probably not.
Okay. How about your dad and mom? What do they think of this?
My mom is iffy about it, but my dad's okay with it.
I look at him smiling there from ear to ear. He's happy about that. Mm-hmm. And what weight do you fight at?
80.
80 pounds? You're kidding me.
No.
You going to get bigger?
Hopefully.
Not yet. I'd keep fighting where you're at.
Yeah.
If you can fight here and win, do it.
Mm-hmm.
That's a key thing. So you're going to get ready for Golden Gloves this year coming up?
Yeah, I'm going to try to do my best.
And how was it when you got in the Golden Glove tournament last year? Were you nervous, excited, or all those above?
I was nervous, and I was excited because it was my first fight. And
just like this is your first interview.
Uh-huh.
You're doing pretty good.
Thank you.
I keep interrupting you with questions, though. How you handling it? You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, good. We'll keep going on.
All right.
All right, so your first fight, how did that go?
I was good. I won.
Your second fight?
I won.
Was it harder or difficult? Or?
It was about the same as the first one.
And then what's the championship after that? Or was there a third fight and then a fourth?
There was a third, but there's not a fourth yet.
No? So you won the championship in the third fight?
I won the championship, the second fight, but then I lost the third fight.
Okay, because we do the Golden Gloves, so we see a lot of fighters. I recognized your name,
yeah.
So I wasn't sure if we announced the one when you won or not. So, but it's a tough sport.
Yeah, it is.
And you got to come back from those losses, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you're ready.
Yes, I am ready.
I can't wait to see you this year.
Thank you.
Well, good luck to you. Thanks for being a guest, Ryan.
You're welcome.
Anybody you want to say hi to on this?
No.
Okay, get out of here. Been a while since you've been on the show. Tell everybody your name.
Hi, I'm Colleen Davis.
Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you too.
How's boxing going?
It's going well. In the gym every day. I won the Golden Gloves this year.
Congratulations. We saw that.
Thank you. So I have a title to retain this upcoming spring, so I'm working towards that goal.
You're going
to
defend it?
Yes.
Wow.
Next division. I'm going into the open division now, so.
Get on.
Yeah.
Wow, you're moving on up.
Yep.
Can't beat that. Now, do you do road work and workouts?
Yes, absolutely. Constantly. It's like constantly on my mind. I'm running.
And does your coach, trainer, always say stuff like that too about training?
Yeah, we're a different breed. Jose and I are on the same page. You know, we're, you got to be a little bit crazy to be a boxer. And
I concur.
We're on the same page with things, you know. He understands, like, we have a goal and a dream to, you know, build, and he helps.
Well, you want to get better. You want to get better from when you started out and what you're doing now.
Yes, and it's amazing, like, how far you can come after, you know, a couple years.
I know. I remember when you started.
Me too. That first fight wasn't as good as the last fight.
Well, you come back from a lot of adversity in the ring.
Yes.
You did that for sure, and you just hit another level with what you're doing. I'm proud to know you and what you've done.
Thank you.
And the face that you put on a photo that our guest Douglas Kavanaugh said he likes that determination in the look.
Uh-huh. Yeah, shout out to Douglas Kavanaugh. We've never actually met in person, but he's somebody that, you know, I connected with on Facebook just about boxing and about, you know, the history of boxing.
Well, he's that.
Yes.
He's all that.
He's all that. Very talented, knowledgeable man. So shout out to that guy.
Now, do you have any other friends that are boxing also? Or did they become friends? Were they friends before, or are they after? Because we got ladies' night here, so I assume all your ladies are friends to a certain degree.
Yes. My best friend, Jane Quinlan, her and I actually started boxing together in high school. So we had a different trainer back then. And
Well, things do change.
Yeah.
You start out, like, where'd you go to high school?
I went to Shaler. Okay. Yes. So,
there's something wrong with him.
No, I did. I went to Shaler, and her and I started out just as, like, fitness, you know.
What made you get started? Fitness?
Yeah.
And then how did you get into getting hit and hitting others? That's what my main question is with all of you.
Fitness, took some time off, made some mistakes, and then I came back to it. And I met Jose and came to Sharpsburg, and the rest is history. I'm not leaving.
Yeah, you're a winner.
So, thank
you. You're a winner now.
Thank you.
And you're going to the Open.
Yes. Yep, Open so Division.
You got things to do.
Yes.
Now, how often do you work out a week?
We're there in the
gym. Be honest.
At least 5 days a week. And when I'm not there, I'm thinking about why I'm not there. And, you know.
This is one dedicated boxer.
So, I mean, that's one thing I can give myself credit for is I put the work in. So.
Well, you're determined, right?
Yes, absolutely.
And how about getting hit? Doesn't that bother you at times?
No, not anymore. I'm like immune to it anymore. Like, you'll get a good one, but when it happens now in sparring, I kind of just giggle. Like, all right, okay, I'm gonna get you back one. You know, it's the name of the game. And if you can't hang, maybe you should do ballet or something else. I mean,
you're killing smoking gym here. Huh? I'm glad you took that photo. I'm glad you took that photo with him. You know.
I love smoking Jim.
Isn't he the best? One of the nicest guys ever.
He's the greatest. Very intelligent man, entertaining man.
How about that smile on him?
Oh, handsome too.
Definitely. We just don't know how old he is.
Age is just a number. You don't need to know that.
That's what he says. Yeah. I wonder you're a friend of his.
No, he's
You can come back on the show just for talking like that.
Hey, I'll come back anytime.
Well, we're glad to have you. Do you got anything else you want to bring up? What you're doing or?
Oh, no, I'm just training, working and training. And it's my dad's birthday, so I'll say happy birthday to him.
I'll say happy birthday to him since he liked my interview with Mr. Douglas Kavanaugh.
Oh, yeah.
And I friended him on that. Tim's his first name, right?
Yes.
So I do know him and thanked him for his kind words about the interviews on the show since we do have a lot of fans. We're at like 6,400 likes, so there's a bunch of people, you know.
Blowing up.
Now I got my smartphone. I can check that all the time.
Oh, that's good.
Well, thanks for being on the show, Carl.
Thank you.
You have a good day.
Thank you. Thank you, guys.
And good luck in all you do.
Thank you.
You know, my hardest first question is, tell us your name.
Aaliyah Zelopis.
Nice to see you. I always wonder what color hair you're going to have, because Smokin' Jim loves your hair.
I know, you never know what kind I'm going to have, right?
I didn't know.
Every year I'm trying something different. I don't know what it'll be next.
Well, you look good. Hard to believe you're a boxer.
Yeah, I've been doing it for almost 3 years now. This will be my third Golden Gloves.
Get out. What got you interested in being in the ring? What happened to you?
I was doing a kickboxing class, and then I heard about a boxing gym next to my home, and
Walked down to it?
Yeah, I walked down to it, and I loved it, and I got along with all the girls there, and I got invited to a fight, couldn't stop screaming my head off, and ended up joining and being in the ring later that week. And
what gym was it?
Ray Schaefer Boxing Gym.
I had to get it out there. That's my man. That's why he's here.
Yeah.
We're trying to keep that together.
Of course, Ray Schaefer Boxing Gym. That's where I'd be.
So you went from kickboxing to boxing.
Yeah, I've been in almost every sport since I was a kid, but nothing.
Really?
Yeah.
Where'd you go to high school?
I did Shaler Area High School.
Okay, more Shaler girls.
Yeah, more Shaler girls. I've been there since I was a kid, so yeah.
Nice. Did you play any high school sports?
I played almost every sport under the sun. Just
officially, I'm saying.
Yes, officially. Almost everything. I did.
All right, this interview's over. Name one or two of them.
Okay. I was a competitive.
I need to hear them.
I was a competitive cheerleader for Force Athletics.
Okay.
And I also was on the volleyball team for Shaler Area.
So. There we go. I got it out of you. I'm glad we could hear that.
Yeah.
So you've always been active and athletic.
Yes.
So do you work out each week?
Yes, I do. We work out probably like 4 to 5 times a week. So.
All right, we got that story pretty straight. I'm digging deep.
Basically, right. You're getting to my roots.
Definitely. And you're a champ also, right?
Yeah. I was, for the first year in the Golden Gloves, I was a Golden Gloves champion.
That's all great that you've had success and you have to work to keep at it.
Yeah, it's a very hard sport, but you got to stay determined and you have to have ambition and keep going with it.
And guess what? Somebody's there trying to knock the snot out of you, pardon me.
Yeah, but I'm also trying to do the same.
Well, that's what boxing is. But yeah. Somebody is trying to hit and hurt you and get you out of the competition first.
Well, I'm always the one who has the blade nose. When I can walk up a set of stairs and bleed, you know.
So. That's your fate. It's how you work around it, I know. You got good cut men in a corner.
Basically, but it makes me fight a little bit more because I'm like, oh, look, everybody thinks I'm bleeding, so I have to fight a little bit more. But it's
it actually inspires you? Are you serious?
Yeah, I like
good
seeing
for
my
you.
Blood on them. So I try to aim for their blood on me.
With logic like that, how can you go wrong? Keep doing what you're doing, Aaliyah.
The way of a boxer.
Yeah, it never ends. And obviously you love the sport because
yeah.
You're still in it.
I'm going 3 years strong, and I'm hoping to be around for a long time.
Really?
Yeah.
How long do you think you'll do this boxing?
Hopefully all the way up to an Olympic trial maybe one day.
Get on.
Yeah.
That's good for you. Congratulations. I like hearing that.
Thank you.
It's nice to talk to motivated people.
That's basically what our whole team is about, just trying to work hard and accomplish the American dream, you know?
And move forward and win titles and get all that other good stuff.
Yep. Do some traveling, get some wins under our belt, and get some belts, too.
Well, that sounds like a plan. I would hope so. You don't want to just come there and bleed on them.
Exactly, right. No one would just want that.
I didn't mean to take that off of you. That seems special for you.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard work. It just shows that you're still in the game.
Well, you're in shape. You just can't help it. They hit you in the nose and it bleeds. Some people are prone to that. We know a lot of the boys and guys, some are bleeders. They're great fighters. And they just get a little tap and they're bleeding. And that seems to have happened to you. You're wearing the headgear. And then you got to...
I think it happened because my first year in volleyball, some girl, she elbowed me in the nose, and she completely broke it from doing it. So I think that's why my nose is so sensitive now. But...
That's a good theory, but it's how you get beyond it.
Now it's just the normal thing for me, you know? Yeah. But everybody kind of gets discouraged, and I step up and show them that you shouldn't be.
Let them get discouraged, but you'll take care of business.
Exactly.
No, I like your style. Good luck to you. It's a pleasure interviewing
you.
You. And that's a nice color of hair. Oh,
thank you. It's not too wild this time.
No.
Thank you so much, guys.
You're welcome. All right, my hardest question, what's your name?
Jane Quinlan.
Thank you very much. It's still the same.
Yeah.
I've seen you box. I've seen you at the Ray Schaefer gym there.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Not a whole lot right now. Just
getting ready for January to start.
Yeah, waiting for
stepping it up.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
You ready for it? Mentally?
Mentally, yes. Physically, not yet.
You got to work on it.
I got a little bit more work to go, yeah.
Well, what got you into boxing? I don't know if I ever asked you that question. Yes.
The movie, Million Dollar Baby.
Are you serious? That's a great movie.
Yeah, I want to be just like her, minus the ending.
I was going to say, you got to cut the ending.
No.
The ending is not a good ending.
No.
Terrible. But it's the movie, so
yeah,
that happens.
It's a good movie, though.
Great movie.
Yeah,
I've watched it a few times.
My pap showed it to me. So.
He's responsible for this.
Responsible.
So what did you do after you got excited about that movie? You go, I want to box.
Yeah, pretty much. And then I looked for a place. And whenever I first kind of started, I actually started in this place in Etna. And
where are you from?
Etna, Shaler.
Wow, everybody's from Shaler. I notice a
trend.
Yeah.
So then, but then I quit for a while. And I don't know if you ever met my cousin Jake, Jake Quinlan. He used to fight.
I've heard of his name. I think I might have.
Yeah, he fought for Jose, and that's actually how I found his gym, was because I went to Jake's.
Your cousin.
I went to Jake's first fight, and after watching the fights and everything, I was just like, I have to do this. Like, I need to do this. And I asked Jake, I was like, does your trainer train girls? Like, does he have any girlfriends?
That's a great question.
Because some people won't. And he's like,
they don't think girls should fight.
I don't know why. We work harder than the boys.
I know. My hat goes off to you.
And he was like, I'll have to ask. And Jose said, yeah. So here I am.
Then you started up.
Yep.
Wow. Did you know what you were getting into?
Yes and no. Like, that's obviously the main thing I was worried about was, am I going to be able to handle getting hit and then keep going? You know what I mean?
I would think that would be what most
people
would, boys or girls.
Yeah.
Because what do you do after that?
Yeah, I'm like, if I get hit, am I going to keep going? Or am I going to stop? Like, am I just going to be like, nope. But first time sparring, getting hit, nah, it was a breeze.
Get out. No problem. Like, we can do this.
So do this. So.
Come on.
Yeah, I'm like, let's do it.
Then you hit them.
Yep. I'm like.
And that's what got you started.
A break for a little bit, and I came back, and I started sparring. I'm like, whoever thought I would ever miss getting punched in the face?
It's an odd thing, but that's what boxing is, and obviously you like it. You're back doing it.
It's a love-hate relationship with boxing.
Yeah.
I hate putting the work in, but
you have to put the work.
Yeah.
You got to do road work and work out a little bit, keep in shape.
Work out a little bit. You got to work out all the time.
Well, this time of year.
Yeah.
You can enjoy the holidays, right?
No. The one time I had to skip, like, Thanksgiving dinner because I had a fight, like, the next week. I love Thanksgiving.
You got to reschedule that. Jeez.
No. It's my favorite holiday, and I had to miss it. I was so upset.
Thanks for sharing that with us. Well, this year, hopefully, you had Thanksgiving.
I did.
You look happier.
Because I went all out on Thanksgiving. And I graduate this week, so.
You graduate from where?
Nursing school.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Stress is leaving my shoulders.
You look taller now, too.
Yeah, see?
That weight's off your shoulder.
Yeah,
and you're still going to continue boxing, like this year for sure.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
Golden gloves.
Yep. No doubt.
Got to do it.
Yep.
Support your teammates, too.
Of course. Always got my teammates' backs.
Yeah. And you guys, I assume, work out together, hit each other, and all that good stuff. Does it get pretty crazy with some sparring, or... How does that go? I know you got to be competitive.
I mean, the girls are competitive, but I don't think we take it as personally as, like, the guys do when they're sparring. Like, some of the
guys, I've seen the guys spar.
They get,
it's crazy.
A bit more competitive. Like, and I think sometimes they leave the ring more angry. Like, the girls, when we're done, we're like, oh, that was a really good punch in the face you gave me. Like, good job.
That's hilarious.
Everybody knows, oh, good job. Like, You did awesome.
I wondered the psychology on that, because I'm not a boxer. I announced boxing and have been around it my whole life, you know, but I never boxed. I played other sports.
Yeah, the guys, I feel like they're a little bit more cold, and then they warm up later. They're like, oh, yeah, good job. But the girls are just like, oh.
They're good right afterwards.
Yeah, we're good.
Most of them.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for that analysis of that. I wondered how it was. Now you've answered my questions. Yeah. What else do you have here? You don't got any more. Let me. I think we've covered it all. You started boxing. What year? How old were you? Never mind. I don't want to ask your age. Then we'll know how old you are now.
Forever. I don't even know.
How, you've been boxing a couple years then?
Well, when I first started at Aetna, I had to have been like at least in 10th or 11th grade, I think.
So you may have been boxing when you started 5 years now.
High school for eight.
Wow.
Yeah, more. No, longer than eight.
Wow. I was trying to be nice.
Longer than that. Sometimes I feel like I'm too old for this, but whatever.
Okay, you've been boxing for over 10 years. How's that? I don't want to get in trouble here.
I only just started fighting a couple years ago, though.
That's what I was getting to. Yeah. You've been fighting the last two.
Yeah.
All right, that's fair.
I got into it later. Whatever.
You're a late bloomer.
Better late than never.
Yeah. Well, as long as you enjoy it, and that's what counts. It sounds like you do. I want to wish you best of luck.
Thank you.
Good luck in everything you do, and congrats on that nursing school.
Thanks. I can't wait.
Now you got to do that.
Yep. All right.
All right. Take care.
Thank you.
And to this day, Chris, Scrooge is synonymous with greed or miser, which just goes to show you the impact Dickens had on the English language.
He's a hack, and his portrayal of ghosts is borderline offensive.
Huh. Oh, hey, George.
Who's this?
Oh, this is the ghost of Christmas Chris. Christmas Chris, did I say that right? That's a bit of a tongue twister. Are you sure you don't want to change it? All right. Well, anyway, Chris here has been helping me out this holiday season.
What do you need him for when you got me?
Maybe because I can do this.
So what? I can do this.
I can see through walls.
So can I.
I can haunt the courtyard.
I can haunt the halls.
I can make myself as big as King Kong.
I can make myself as big as Godzilla.
Well, I can reenact a scene from Ghost.
Can you get this penny out of my face?
Well, I can reenact the scene from Ghostbusters.
It's time for me to show you the door.
Oh yeah? You and whose army?
Fellas, is this any way for holiday spirits to behave?
I guess you're right.
Alright, come on, show a little Christmas cheer. That's much better. And I'm glad we got that squared away, because honestly, you're not the only two ghosts helping me out this year.
I'm not gonna fight with him.
Welcome to our show. My first question is, what's your name?
Alexis Gorham.
Alexis, thanks for answering. Gorham? Say your... Okay. Let's hear that last name one more time.
Gorham.
Gorham. I got it. Okay. That's what I was trying. And you can be quiet. We'll be talking into the mic. You don't have to yell or anything like Smoking Jim. I don't. I'm the opposite of that, so. What got you started in boxing?
my bad attitude. My mom wanted me to, like, know how to defend myself if I ever got in a fight.
And when was this?
When I was in eighth grade.
Okay. So now you've been doing this a couple years.
Yep. Now I'm in 12th. So it's been a decent amount of time.
4 years?
Yep.
I can do the math. How's your grades in school?
Pretty good.
Okay. We won't test you on anything. 12 minus 8 is 4 then.
All right.
Now, you first went to the gym. What did you say? Well, talking to Jose, you didn't have to say anything. Get over here and we'll put you in.
Yep, pretty much.
I know that. And then he'll show you some things.
Yeah.
Okay. But you didn't really ask, like, what I have to do?
No.
My mom told me to be here.
Yeah, but I love
it. You told him that. You do?
Yeah.
And you enjoy it?
Yep.
And I heard you're a champion, too.
Yeah, for the most part, I guess.
Did you win a fight?
No. My first fight, I got a split decision.
How could that happen?
I don't know.
They're testing you. And then did you fight again?
No.
Just one fight?
Yeah.
And when was this?
Last year sometime.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now you're going to try for Golden Gloves this year?
Yep.
You're working towards it?
Yeah.
You're goal-oriented?
Yeah.
And you're still quiet?
Yeah.
Okay.
I've always been quiet. Doesn't get much louder.
Well, Jose can make up for that in his team.
Yeah, for sure.
He's not going to stop. Just like we'll have him talk on the end of the show here because he can carry it out.
Yeah, he does
get pretty loud there.
He does, for sure.
And he'll tell you what to do in the ring, which is actually helpful at times, too.
It's very helpful.
And you got to listen. It's hard to listen to your coach, but his voice does carry.
For sure. Definitely true.
And then he has Jose the 14th backing him up. So he does come up with some good ones, and he's a smart kid.
He's very smart.
In school also.
Yeah.
Definitely. So let's see. Do you play any other sports?
Yeah, I play basketball and softball.
Do you? How do you do in those sports?
Pretty good.
Does anybody mess with you?
Not at all.
They know you're a fighter.
Yep.
Where do you go to school at?
Oakland Catholic.
Oh, okay. That's a nice school. Good reputation.
Yeah, for the most part. I like it.
You
win? I like it.
Yeah, yeah, with that grimace.
Yeah.
Well, that's where you're going to school, so you got to like it.
Yeah, I guess so.
What else can you do? Go to the gym and get hit.
Yeah.
Or hit somebody. Do you like to hit people?
Yeah. Yeah, but I don't mind getting
hit.
Are
you past those anger issues that you had?
Yeah. Yeah, I think so.
Would you recommend boxing to other kids that you know?
Yeah, because it's a great way to, like, just, like, get fit and...
Get stuff out of your system.
For sure.
Did I say it right?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, it makes sense. I'm just proud to know people that get into it for different reasons and then continue it. Because you could just quit.
Yeah.
But say, I did it, and now I know how to defend myself.
Yeah.
But you're staying with it, so I admire that.
It's so much fun.
Do you have fun at it?
Yeah. I love it. That's probably my favorite sport that, like, I do.
Out of the other two?
Yeah.
Get up.
Yep.
Do you play often on the basketball court?
Yeah, a lot.
Are you a shooting guard? How'd I guess?
I don't know.
How many points do you score a game? Two or three?
Yeah, we'll stick with that.
Well, I'm glad you play other sports. You like this boxing thing. Do you thank your mom for guiding you that way?
Yeah, definitely.
She gets a couple props for that?
Yeah. She doesn't always like it, but...
No. What doesn't she like?
Probably when I get punched in the face. But I don't mind it, so it's okay. I don't know.
You get a chance to punch them in the face, too. Right?
You got to make sure you're
fast. What you get, you can give it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hopefully more often than not, you hit them.
Yeah, hopefully.
Well, I want to wish you good luck for this
season. Thank you.
Good luck in the ring.
Thanks.
Basketball, volleyball, whatever else you're doing. And good luck in school.
Thanks.
Thank you. All right. We got the Puerto Rican Prince back in business. It was great interviewing your lady boxers.
Thank you. Yeah, they're a great team. A great team to work with.
They got a great spirit there.
Yeah.
No quit attitude. and I was trying to say that you talk a lot, and they all agreed.
Yep.
And I was saying that they could hear you. How do you hear your coach? But they're able to hear you. So they all agreed.
Yeah.
I mean, your reputation precedes you, my friend.
Yeah.
I enjoy being the color guy with Smoke and Jim on the play-by-play.
Yeah.
And we get some interaction with you during the boxing.
Yeah, I know. And sometimes I get carried away.
No. We don't. This isn't Dr. Phil.
Right. Because I was just going to apologize because I'm going to do it again this year. You know.
Well, let me just tell you, I didn't want to waste any time on an apology because I've seen you, and you said you're not going to do it next time, and you don't want to go to the judges' card.
No.
Now, it's hard in headgear to knock people out.
It is.
And I've seen your gym do it,
yes.
And your boxers do it,
yes.
Although it's 1 out of 10 maybe, or, you know, something like that.
Well, unless you're talking about my fighters like Matt Kearns, he got 4 out of 5.
Wow. Wow.
You know, Mike Rakowski.
Yeah, I didn't want to bring out the hammer.
Yeah.
But those things happen, so it sort of carries through your gym, and the others are trying, but they don't have that natural knockout ability.
No, they don't. But, I mean, if the ones who don't, I believe every fighter has a different style, so every fighter at my gym gets trained a different way. I'm not saying everybody on the bag do the same thing, you know. So I think if they don't have knockout power, I'll teach them how to set them up. You know what I mean? To knock them out.
And then you're telling them during the whole fight to set them up for that.
Yeah.
So I appreciate it. I know your style. And speaking of your style, I always had this question. What got you started in the boxing? Because I know you grew up in McKees Rocks, and we talked a little bit about that. But what got you started?
My uncles, my family. You know, my sister, actually, Darcy. You know,
yeah.
Smoking Jim, you know, my sister. Yes. She was a big fight fan when I was younger, believe it or not. When I was younger.
Really?
Yeah. I would come in the room, and she would say, sit down and watch us, and they would be watching guys like Julio Cesar Chavez.
Get out.
Yeah, Hector Macho Camacho. Guys that were on HBO at that time, big names, you know. And my uncles were professional fighters. My uncle fought Buddy McGirt in Madison Square Garden.
Get out.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. So I come from the you know.
Fighting family.
Yeah, and when we were younger, they used to always put gloves on us and say, come on, you know, let's work. So we would work out, and we would fight and everything like that. And being from McKees Rocks, of course, the Pittsburgh kid.
Paul Spadafora.
Yeah, you know. Excuse me. When you have a guy like that, and he's right on the same blocks that you're on, walking every day.
You're growing up with him.
Yeah,
a little behind. But.
Right. But this guy, you know, I mean, he's an arm's length away from having the world, you know. He was setting it up.
Oh, he was looking awesome.
Unbelievable talent. But anyway, because of that, it opened the gate to a lot of different fighters in McKees Rocks and Pittsburgh. Paul opened the door, reopened the door that was once open but shut on us.
That's a key statement. He reopened it.
Yes.
There was always boxing. Boxing had been big in the 80s and stuff still, and then it tapered off.
Yes,
you know,
did.
So he caused a resurgence.
He did, and I think I think we would really be hurting if we didn't have that kid in his history.
There's no doubt in my book there. A lot of bad things happened to him, and he's overcome it. He's retired now, but just unbelievable fighter.
Unbelievable talent with the natural ability. To
not get hit.
Yeah. He'd come to my gym a couple times, you know, just I knew him for a long time. So he would come up, and he'd say to me, you know, I'd hold the mitts for him and work, and we would work on some things. And I would say to him, Paul, just go back to what you were God-given, your talent, your natural ability. People try to say, come to my gym, Paul. And then they try to slap an S on his chest, and Paul got power now, and Paul got this. Just let Paul do what he does. You know what I mean? It's
makes
natural,
sense.
God-given ability. You can only.
But that shows you as a trainer, a coach, you have an open eye, and you're willing to learn from the people that come to your gym because you have to be flexible. That's one of the key things, you know, you're known for.
Yeah. I mean, 22 years I've been in the game here. 22, man.
Wow.
That's insane. It's crazy, but I mean.
Tell them where your gym's at.
My gym's in Sharpsburg. Sharpsburg, right off of Route 28, right outside of Fox Chapel.
Tell them. It's easy to find.
It is. It's right there. You know, you can look us up on the Facebook. We have a gym page there for the Ray Schaefer Boxing Association. Everything's going good over here. We have a lot of kids in the gym and off the streets this year.
So. That's what counts. It's all about these kids. You're getting them off the streets. They're coming in. Their mother says, want to learn defense, and they're learning stuff like that, get them out of trouble, you know, just different things like that, which is great.
And it teaches a lot of discipline, self-discipline, respect, you know what I mean, dedication. I think it's a great thing for every, like, not every single person, you know, it's for, I think somebody should, everyone should try it, I think, you know what I mean, just to get the feeling of.
Well, they'll earn respect of the sport, and that's one of the things that a lot of people, me being around, I never boxed, but I have a story that I've told people. My dad's cousin was a boxer back in the 30s. Well, his name was called Kid Doogie. I don't know whether he fought out of New York or something. But when he come to my house, he ended up retiring to Galveston, Texas. Come up to our house, it was me and my three sisters. I'm about 6 years old, and the other sisters are all younger. And this guy come around, he's punching, shadow boxing in the house. Then he goes, I'm going out for a run. And he had cauliflower ears. He had a nose that was like, he had a face that stopped the clock. Look, my watch, I can't even wear it. And he had this old brief, this piece of luggage that he set on the side. He goes, I'll be back. Well, I lived on a street right next to Parkway West, Park Edge and Sheldon, about a mile and a half circle. He goes and runs that.
Yeah.
Comes back. Now he's in his late 60s. Comes in. He's shadow boxing some more. He goes to me, hey, kid, let's box a little. He's throwing fists at me. It intrigued me. And then he opens up his luggage, and he goes, you got to worry about what you eat, kid, too, so you can stay in shape. Now, he looked like 150 pounds, you know, in good shape. You know, you hit him, sort of like you.
Yeah. I'll tell you what.
But that got me interested when I was like 6 years old.
Yeah. And see something like that, it opens your eyes, you know what I mean? Just for a second, take a glance
and,
at it.
And, you know, I'd go to my dad, you know, who's that? And he goes, oh, Kid Doogie. I even forget his real name.
I'll tell you what, guys, fighters from back then cut from a totally different cloth, man. They don't make them like that anymore. Those guys, and like even up through the Rocky Marciano, era and everything.
Whole
like
different mentality.
Yeah. They
lived and died with that. They breathed. And,
yeah, guys like Jake LaMotta. Where are they at today? You know, I have a lot of respect.
They'd say he's crazy.
Yeah, and I have a lot of respect for every one of us, every one of the professional and amateur athletes that step in the ring. But I haven't seen a guy step in the ring and looking like Jake LaMotta. Outside of, like, you know, rest in peace with Arturo Gotti.
Mm-hmm. Good point.
Arturo Gotti was a guy, you know, he was a throwback fighter. You know, he would fight
There's a
anybody.
Few. Every so often you have a couple of these guys. They come back, they're truly old school.
Right, but no matter if they win or lose, they want to fight the best. You know, they want to fight the best. Gotti wasn't making $260 million like Floyd Mayweather was, but Gotti would fight
anybody.
Anybody, you know what I mean? So that's the fighters that I like. I like guys like that. Fight for history.
What's the goals for your gym when you got these kids coming in off the street? You got some that are true athletes that are playing other sports.
Right.
And they have, you know, exceptional reflex, you know, different things like that. And you scout them all. You know their ins and outs. You even go in the ring with them.
Yes, yeah. You know, it's funny you say that. Now I'm getting different athletes from different sports for, like, physical training, strength conditioning.
Sure, I know you've opened up and branched out.
Right. So I'm getting a lot of that. But as far as the boxing talent that comes in the gym, I don't try to push anyone. My trainer, Spacky DeLeo, used to say, you can't make them fight, Coom. Can't force a fighter to fight. I see that now. You know what I mean? I learned that because people wouldn't want to, and I would
try. They balk at it.
Yeah. So, I mean,
But you don't stop. You're relentless.
Yeah, I know. I keep going. But now
like me here.
Right. Now I see that, like, opportunity for them. If they want to fight in the Golden Gloves, come in, learn to box, fight in the Golden Gloves.
Try it this year.
It's helping with their scholarships. Yeah. Give it a try. You know what I mean? If you're going to school.
And they're high school kids. They're coming in.
High school kids. I got kids. The youngest kid in my gym now, I think, is 9 years old. And then I have a guy, you know, Jeff Cross, who'll be fighting the Golden Gloves this year and the Masters at 55.
That's great. Good luck to you.
Real good fighter. He is unbelievable. His training is insane. I can't keep up with him.
What?
I can't keep up with
him. You're acting too much. That's why. You're an actor.
No, this guy does a lot of, like, the military recon. Like training, like the Army Rangers.
That's an extreme stuff.
It's unbelievable. Like, one day I said, well, let's go through your workout. I regretted it for about 5 days. My body was killing me.
Get out. Yeah. Wow. That's amazing stuff.
Yeah. But we're doing good out there, you know, and we're keeping a lot of kids off the street, and that's the point. And we're trying to be part of this, bring boxing back to Pittsburgh.
I can't wait to see your boxers and fighters and you in the ring again.
I know.
No, I mean outside the ring. Not in the ring. Once in a while you get in.
Yeah, I get a little antsy. Good to climb up there, you know. But
no, it's good. I wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Thanks for having your peeps come out here. It was an honor to have them.
We love coming down.
If you want the boys to hit a show, we can do that in January.
That would be fine. If you guys have any room for us, we'd love to come down.
We'll make some room for your gym.
I got a good
gym. I guarantee it. I want to see them all.
That sounds good to me.
Take care.
Hey, thank you, guys. Thank you for having me. All right, take care.
Good luck. Thanks, everybody. Go eat your sandwich. I know I got to.